Today we are at Wild Ginger Apothecary. This is one of my favorite spots in Sarasota. It's a little store here. It's got great natural products and something that we do for all of our clients that are going through our program anyway and they're detoxing. We want to take them in here and show them basically all the natural skincare products, natural makeup. She has even cleaning products, things like that. Especially for anyone that's detoxing, we don't want them using all the toxic stuff for their face and the makeup and the lipstick and putting all the toxins back in. So we're going to do a little tour here and hope you'll learn a little something about Wild Ginger.
Stars creak as you sleep, it's keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And some days I can't even trust myself.
It's killing me to see this way.
Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry our body safe to shore.
We have are going to be, I'm the only person in Sarasota or sometimes the only person in Florida that will have them. They're all small batch, a lot of like owner-operated tiny companies. But Kensington is the best line that I have as far as like skin type specific and, you know, function specific. And they have a really nice serum and oil composition that you can use, you know, one or both. Mm-hmm. And if you're looking for anti-aging, do you spend a lot of time in the sun, or have you?
I used to spend a lot of time in the sun. Now I haven't really been in the sun since July, but a couple of times. But it's like, plus losing weight, and then I just turned 50, you know, it's like, oh my God, I'm getting old. You know what I mean? So I kind of cut back from the sun, but I used to be a sun worshiper for years.
The sun, if you spend a lot of time in the sun, I keep a couple of these on hand, but I always use that if I've been spending a couple of days in the sun. Mm-hmm. But it also is really popular with people who have spent a lot of time in the sun in the past. So it really is like going to be the most complex of everything I have as far as like, you know, reversing sun damage.
Okay. There's no magic potion that you can apply to your skin if you have a bad lifestyle.
Right.
But you can get cleaner skincare products that will not have the chemicals.
Right.
That will help lubricate the skin and moisturize.
Okay. But over-toning and over-cleansing is like the biggest challenge that people have with their skin, of all ages, all skin types.
It's considered an antidepressant.
Right. Okay, so I've used...
So this has...
This is the stick one of this?
Yeah, it's a stick one of that. It's designed to be a little bit more mainstream and people are really fixated on it being in a stick.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily that much easier to use because it's still pretty soft.
Okay.
You still have to kind of use your hands to get it into the right spot. This is the similar version to that, but designed for sensitive skin. So if you're irritated easily, or if that's been problematic for you, sometimes people get a little rash or break up from the baking soda. This one has a really tiny amount of baking soda, so it's same sort of efficacy, but with a little bit more gentle formulation, and then like with the antibacterial thieves formula.
Do you know what's in it?
And this is the one that Brian got, I think.
That one, yeah. I feel like I've used all the other natural deodorants I've used that like just don't work well, do you know? But this works well for me. Like, what's in it that you're finding?
It's a combination of the baking soda in particular.
Okay.
You know, that's your big thing, and then their essential oil blends. And
so you know, part of the baking soda, because of all the natural deodorants, are not antiperspirants, but the baking soda helps.
It does help to absorb some moisture, so they can't call it an antiperspirant because it's not trapping that moisture, but it does still absorb some moisture. And so does this. I mean, this one does the same thing. This is just a little bit stronger, so that also makes it a little...
My crazy saging rituals, where I get rid of all the evil spirits. Do we want that on film?
Do you do them?
We also use some of the sprays that you have.
That's the black cherry.
Just clearing out energy. Like after a client, after acupuncture or something, like to just spray them.
You might just do it and just
whatever
switch,
they left,
you know what I mean?
There, I just want it to go away.
If you're trying to
make it.
Yeah. Okay.
Basically. This one has almond oil with it. That's why it's a little bit thicker. So it's more of a body oil. It's a little bit heavier. Personally, I mean, like, I would use this on my face because it's thicker and I have drier skin. Mm-hmm. Okay. But, you know, it gives you the same raw benefits
of
the coconut oil
face?
I have. Well, I meant, like, comparatively.
Yeah.
But also has essential oils in it, but it's really just
oh, this feels good.
Blended with almond
it's
oil
nice.
For
doesn't it smell
deeper,
good?
Deeper hydration. Yeah, that's
called. Organic digestive bitters. That's a refillable herbal travel spray. Okay, so
it's
digestive
all essential
bitters.
Oils.
Yeah. Great
so it's
for
good for digest. It's for gas,
any,
bloating, heartburn, liver support.
Like you could just have that in your purse.
Yeah, if you eat somewhere and not feeling very good.
That's so cute.
Your mind is playing tricks on you, my dear. Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Don't listen to a word I say. The screams all sound the same. Though the truth may.
Using on your lips?
Well, sometimes I get like that dollar lipstick.
No,
I don't know what this is. I don't know.
Loose.
Okay, this might be CoverGirl.
Most likely petroleum and other ingredients that
yeah,
you don't
I'm
eat.
Not
That's
sure.
crucial, Tammy, because what you're putting on your lips, you're eating most of it.
Yeah, and my lips are.
You want it to be as pure
not
as possible.
Healthy then. Because I'm sure that.
So while we're getting rid of all your metals that you're just putting back on.
Right, so I'm just putting them back in.
You're doing all the detoxing and you're just like, I just put a new dose of lead on. Tammy, this.
4 to 7 pounds a year.
This is. Four, what was that?
The average person
right now.
Or the average woman eats 4 to 7 pounds of lipstick a year.
Oh my god.
If you were to use lipstick every day, I'd be like,
red.
So this would
red.
Be a good on the go, like a lip gloss. I mean, for you, if you want that color that lasts in the way that the cheap lipstick does, I would use a lip liner, especially because you have thinner lips and it would make your lip color last longer.
Right.
That's the biggest challenge for people switching into natural lip colors. Like sometimes it doesn't have the same staying powder without all the chemicals that kind of seal it on.
Better
so I should be getting rid of this stuff that I put on.
That, no. You know what happens? You know what happens with that? It actually does cause lip balm addiction.
Oh, I know.
I used to hear that and think, oh, that's just.
I put this on like 5 times a day.
It's true. It does cause you to be.
Whoops. Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, so we are
going to
try checking out another herb.
Yeah.
Herb here. I hope you enjoyed our little tour of wild ginger and learned. I did want to highlight, you can order online, right? So this is in Sarasota, but you can actually, doesn't matter where you're watching this, you can actually get everything online. What's
yes, wildgingerapothecary.com.
Wildgingerapothecary. We'll put it in the description too, but thank you guys so much for watching.